Good morning, everybody. Vitamin J here. Great day to be alive in the neighborhood. Wanted to continue on with my yoga postures. What I'm going to demonstrate today is a sequence of moves that it's classically known as the Hindu royal court. You can go online and research that and kind of find out a little bit about it yourself. But it's basically three simple moves. They're more of a strength training move as opposed to some of the classic yoga postures that are more of a stretching and lengthening and sort of a decompressing of your nervous system. So I'm going to go ahead and demonstrate these. They're really simple. The first one, we can call it the Hindu squat. I think that's what it's sort of classically known as. And it's real simple. It's just this. Camera can see this. Here we go. So basically, all I'm doing is sort of doing that. And it looks very, very simple. It doesn't look like it's going to build any strength at all. But try doing 100 of these in a row. See if you can get to 100. I won't do 100 in a row here. Once again, you're going to find that you have to be really conscious of your breath. You can do what you want to with your arms. What I'm choosing to do now is to sort of do what I call a torus. They have shown that around the human being is sort of an energetic field shaped as a torus. So I'm sort of trying to expand that field, expand my energy and my power. Do a few more. You can also do this. Listening to some Andre Bocelli. Okay, it's enough of those. You know, maybe try to just do 5 or 10 and then work your way up to doing more and more. There are people who do thousands of these in a row every single day. And again, you know, everything that I'm showing you guys, there are people all over the world who are much more advanced than me. I'm able to go out and sort of, because I'm so into the concept of vibrational frequency and what it takes to raise that, and being vigilant about not being around the things that lower my frequency. So, I don't know, for whatever reason, that's part of my plan, is to discover these batshit crazy things and try to share them with the world. The second move is, I guess we'll call it the Hindu push-up. Superman push-up is another way to do it. I think I demonstrated that in another video, but here it is. It's very simple. Kind of like a downward dog, and then it's just all of a sudden you're just... And again, you have to be in your breath. You have to be breathing. Again, it might not look too difficult, but the goal is to do more and more in a row every day. I can do maybe 100 of these in a row. I won't do that right now. Feels incredible. Okay, the third one is called the, and again, never get caught up in the names of these things. I could call this third one strawberry milkshake. It doesn't matter. What matters is that you're trying things. You're moving your body. Don't try this immediately. This is sort of a demonstration of supernatural power time. but you've got to build yourself up to this move, okay? So again, the warning is don't try this yet. Research it, look into it online, and then play around with it. But it's incredible. I used to have a ton of neck pain, and after I started doing this, the neck pain just went away. Believe it or not, because what you're about to see would seem as though it would cause neck pain, but it doesn't. Here we go. And basically, the move is to try to slowly roll back onto your forehead. You can get to the point where you're almost touching your nose to the ground. You gotta breathe. You can hold that as long as you want, as long as it's comfortable. It feels incredible. Then I like to sort of finish off that move with this. And then maybe do some of these, just to be a show off. There. Okay, that took, let's see, that took 6 minutes, because I'm sure I was bullshitting for a minute or so. 6 minutes and I feel exhilarated, I feel alive, I feel strong. You can do that, it's up to you. Okay? Believe in yourself, have a great day, and until next time, I'll see you later.